Hello everyone and welcome back to the daily update of my 1000 day challenge. This is actually day 12. So as you can see, for S&P 500, it's actually rising up close to the very much the all-time high over here. So could it be potentially heavily rejected? That is yet to be seen, but as of right now, it has yet to be tested. We do get this bearish engulfing candlestick from yesterday, which is a sign of weakness. But let's say, as you can see, there's huge bearish engulfing candlestick, price still continue towards the uptrend. So that single candlestick itself doesn't really mean much per se. But of course, if it does open lower, then it could indeed be a potential retracement to this 20 exponential moving average, where it could be similarly supported and continue upwards. So if you have entered based on this trade setup, as I mentioned, as long as it doesn't close below the 20 exponential moving average, I'll remain within this trade. Otherwise, yep, in terms of investment opportunity, if it does come towards the 50 simple moving average, I'll look to enter in terms of dollar cost of averaging approach. And yep, that's about it. Let's move on to NASDAQ. And in terms of the NASDAQ, what I do see over here is it's been supported here, supported here, supported here, the 20 exponential moving average. So likewise, when you see that, you know, there was a transition from the bearish to the bullish market structure, is where I've entered the long. And so over here, if it does close below this 20 exponential moving average, it will be near my break-even point. That is where I will look to close the trade. But the key thing here that I mentioned is it must go below and closes. It can actually go below, and if it closes above back again, then I wouldn't close my trade on the following day. So that is the methodology that I follow in terms of closing my trade. Alright, so in terms of price action-wise, not too major per se, even though it's a third consecutive red candle, it does show signs of potential weakness. As you can see over here, even though there was three bearish candlesticks, it continued way back upward as well. So nothing too much of a concern. And yep, that's about it. In terms of trade setup, this definitely remains still valid. In terms of investment opportunity, I preferably do prefer at least the 50 simple moving average for adding in my long-term position. All right. And moving on for ASHR, as you see over here is a transition back to bearish market structure. As you can see over here, you can take a pause over here and take a look. There's some changes in terms of the daily market structure today. Say for example, ASHR, there's a transition back to bearish market structure. So potentially there could be further retracement today to retest this 20 exponential moving average region. If it's being supported, it could continue upwards and the correction could have been completed over here. Of course, it could also be a small little correct, a bigger correction Elliott wave, which would be an ABC kind of corrective wave as well. That would be ideal. But otherwise, it could also be an ABC over here and a continuation towards the upside. So as for right now, I will still stay away from it until support has been established or rejection has been established. All right, and let's move on to KWEB. In terms of KWEB wise, similarly, after the break, it was this actually breaks below the 20 exponential moving average. So it does show in terms of a short-term bearish momentum, especially you can see here previously it closes above, even though it breaks below, it closes back above or near it, whereas here it closes decisively below it. So could it potentially be retesting this 50 simple moving average? That would be great. And if we retest this previous support region, resistance and support, that will be even better for adding the long-term position wise. All right, so bear in mind that for ASHR and KWEB, I do not suggest trading. As you can see, the gap in between that is happening can result in high slippage. And also in terms of the, yeah, so that result in high slippage. And also volume-wise, it would be much harder for you to scale in and out in comparison to S&P 500 and NASDAQ. So personally, I do not like to trade stocks. There's these kind of plenty gaps. Or personally, I do not like to trade stocks in general simply because of this potential to gap out quite consistently. And also even in terms of Forex, there's also potential for gapping out as well. Yep. All right. And last but not least, let's look at Bitcoin. So just a quick update on this. I'm not sure why there's seemingly this error over here. For my Bitstamp, I can't seem to see it sometimes. Alright, but if you would just get a Coinbase, right, so you lose the important drawn lines drawn, but that doesn't really matter. What I do see over here, like what I mentioned, is you can see here, there's a higher high, but there's a lower high form on the daily chart. So what this does mean is that it has also transited back to a bearish, a neutral market structure, because you get a higher high, but you get a lower low instead. So this would be a potential transition back to a bearish market structure, or it could be a continuation back to bullish market structure after consolidation. So if you look at the 4-hour chart, it actually transited to a bearish market structure. As you can see clearly over here, with a lower high and lower low formation. So if we do want to enter a long setup, I'll wait for this to transit back to a bullish market structure, which means to say it must form a higher high and a higher low. So right now you got this low, I want a higher low to be formed, followed by a high, and then a higher high to be formed before entering a new long setup per se. Right? So otherwise, that's the update. As you can see for this previous trade, yesterday you wouldn't have seen. So previously, when I mentioned if you have entered this, you have taken your position over here. The remainder 50 of my position I have closed over here. As you can see, the minute this candlestick broke and closes below is where we have closed. So they will be close to your break even or slightly below loss, but that's fine. So you have already taken 50% of your profit. That's great. And right now I'll wait for a transition back to bullish momentum or bullish market structure before entering a new trade setup. So otherwise, that's the quick update for today, and I'll see you guys tomorrow. Take care. Bye-bye.